They have the same name,
teach.
Yes, which is also not in the Bible. It's just alluding to that in the name of X, Y, and Z. Why then you cannot answer my question about the consciousness of God, which is also not categorically mentioned in the Bible. But you seem to know their names. But you don't know whether they have the same consciousness or they have different consciousness, each one of them. A very simple question, Lizzy. I'm sure you will be able to answer, because if Jesus said, I by my will can do nothing, that tells you that his will and the will of the Father is different. In the Garden of Gethsemane, when Jesus, the one that she's claiming to be better than Allah, yes, when he falls on his face, when he falls on his face and he begs his God, what does he beg his God? When he begs his God to take the cup of punishment away from him, yes, guess what? This powerful God of Lizzy gets his prayer rejected. Not one time, not two times, not three times. And you know what Jesus said at that moment as well? Let it be your will, not my will. So there you go. So Jesus is not all powerful. He cannot even get his own prayer accepted. He gets it rejected three times. And on the cross, he cries out like a person without faith. My God, he didn't say my Father, remember. He said, my God, why have you abandoned me? Your powerful God got abandoned by his God. Guess what? After the very promise that he gave to his son, i.e. that if you die for the sins, that sins will be taken away, when the job was done, he got abandoned. He got abandoned for the very thing that he was created to do, according to the Christian scriptures. So there we go. Jesus was abandoned by his God, was denied the prayer. I'm talking about how less powerful your God is, and he doesn't have the same consciousness. Well, I said, I'm still about the being, that this being is not the same as the Almighty God who rejected his prayer. This is not the same being whom Jesus addresses as my God. Because in John 20:17, he says, I go to my God and your God. Again, God cannot have a God. If this is Lizzy's logic that God, Jesus can have a God, then you are a polytheist who believes in more than one God. If you believe that God, the Father, has a different consciousness to the Son and a different consciousness that to the Holy Spirit, then again, we are talking about tritheism, three gods, polytheism. And that's the reason you guys are called kuffar in the Quran, because you disbelieve in the oneness of Allah. And that's the reason you'll be destined for hellfire if you maintain this as your faith.
Preaching.
See, I learned from you, Lizzy. You like to preach?
I'm just going to pick up on one topic.
I think with this, we'll get. Lizzy.
I want to show the difference. Jesus says, those who believe in me, I will be inside them, and they will be inside me.
Lizzy, you make a point, and I make a point, and then we call it.
We have Paul says, I tell him to be good, because evil on Jesus.
Near regions of Moscow.
Who is Paul?
At the back. Stopping young Muslims.
Romans chapter 7:21. How can you follow
them? No, I want to ask him what's your
name. Sorry, I can't hear what
is inside him. You're not following Jesus. You're following the
Jesus. It's not in the Bible. She says she only follows the scripture. I know. But even Paul didn't believe in the Trinity.
Paul is the Antichrist. No, Jesus says, I cannot do good for myself because evil is present within me. Evil, not Jesus. But Jesus says, that's what believe in me.
It's not in the scripture, is it?
In John chapter 3, whoever believes in me, I will be inside them, and they will be inside me. Whoever believes in me, Paul says,
he's not rejected.
I cannot do good.
That's why I love Jesus.
Are you speaking to the camera, not to me? Have you noticed I speak to her, not the camera? But she does that every time. Instead of she asked me, she approached me for a debate, and then she speaks to the camera. This is a tactic of Lizzy, who goes around hunting near the masjid for Muslims who don't know, who are not into apologetics or polemics. She goes and hunts for them, but when she's facing in the speaker's corner, she's given the opportunity to talk to us who have got experience dealing with Christians and apologetics. No, I don't go out. I don't go to the churches and approach. And unsuspecting Christians like the way she does. So are you going to talk to me or to the camera?
Yes, and I'm going to ask you this point. Because you said, and this is what you say to Christians,
which is,
how can God have a God?
He's a sheep.
How can God have a God? You know
He's
what? I've asked myself that same question.
Good.
Let's see.
I hope you got the answer.
It is He who says, how can Allah have a God?
Oh, another topic?
The Quran says, I cannot do good.
Where does Allah have a God?
Where does Allah have a God?
Where does Allah have a God?
It is He. Allah, who sends Salat, his prayers. That means prayers. Don't tell me it means blessings.
It doesn't
mean Arabic doesn't mean blessings.
Which words is that?
It means blessings in Arabic is Barakah. This is Salat, which is just prayer. Okay, it is
which chapter and what is that?
It's He who sends Salat, his prayers on you. Allah sends his prayers on Muhammad.
I know
Allah
that.
Is the biggest mushrik that there ever was.
You use an Arabic word. Wait, I mean. No, you made a claim. I want to clarify that. You use the word salat. Yes? When we say yusalluna ala nabi. Yes? What does it mean? Let's speak in Arabic.
Don't know, but you're avoiding.
I'm not. I'm asking you a question. Because she used an Arabic word. She used an Arabic word and she translated it by herself. What does the word salat mean?
Can I
show you?
Can I
show you? In English, there are what kind of prayer? Is it worship?
To send you salat to you.
It does.
With his angels.
Allah is sending his worship.
She doesn't have the ability.
Allah is sending his worship upon Muhammad. It gets even worse. Allah has
that's
gone
what you
and
think.
Is born of a human creature.
That's your subjective opinion.
That is terrible.
So you think salat is worship
in
Allah?
That's what you said.
Allah has more than one meaning.
Lizzy, do you understand the difference between asking you a question and me answering that? So when I asked you, there's a question to you. So don't jump on your high horse thinking that Allah is worshipping himself or worshipping
Muhammad.
No, it's not worshipping Muhammad. No, it's not praying to God. It's sending greetings and salutations. Because the word salat, wait a minute. Look, do you know Arabic?
Salat means prayer.
Okay, show me where in Arabic dictionary says salat means only prayer. Where it means
only
prayer. Show me the Arabic dictionary. Show me the evidence. Show me the evidence.
He's Arabic.
He's an Arabic teacher. He just shows, you know, these guys, they really, really, they make fun of their own self by using Arabic terms. That they don't know.
Mercy. It shows one of the meanings of the word salah. It means
how do you know it doesn't mean? How do you know he's lying?
She doesn't know Arabic, bro.
What's your name?
She doesn't know the ABC of Arabic.
You know that much.
What is your name?
You can laugh all you like about the fact that I can't speak Arabic.
Do you know what lie means?
Still lying.
Do you know what lie means?
Means prayers. Anyway, you can stop. Let me finish.
You don't know Arabic, and you're using
worshiping a God that has a God.
That is a Christian. The Christian Jesus says, "I go to my God and your God." That is very clear. Jesus puts his head on the floor and worships God.
Muhammad never died for you on the cross.
The two questions I asked her, which were related, were very simple. Does God have consciousness? Sorry, does the Father, the Son, or the Holy Spirit, they have one consciousness or more than one consciousness? So if no, you said you didn't know. And then the second one I asked is, show me in the Bible where it says God is three persons.
Yes.
And she was unable to show us. She showed us that they have one name. One name. Look, Lizzy.
Does the Quran have consciousness?
What's that?
Does the Quran have consciousness?
Look around.
Does the Quran have consciousness?
The Quran, the book. No, the Quran doesn't
have consciousness.
Will it one day have consciousness?
The Quran will not have consciousness.
Yes, it will. That's what the Hadith says. It says that on judgment day, that certain surahs will come to life.
Are you talking to me or the
Quran?
Lizzy, you know, you said salat only means prayer. Okay. Have you actually consulted an Arabic dictionary to look at this word?
Please.
Okay. You know, you had an Arabic expert the last time. Do you know what he said about the word salat? What did he say? What did that Arabic expert tell you?
Prayer.
It's prayer, okay. But when we question him, what is the meaning of the word Allah, he didn't know that. He says a salah, Allah says salah upon. You know, when you, listen, when you pray to someone and send salat upon someone.
So you're admitting it means prayer.
Can I finish? Can I finish?
Thank you.
No, I will not. I haven't finished. Salat, wait, I use the word salat. I didn't use the word prayer. I said that's the word salat. So stop interrupting and try to understand. Because the Arabic expert failed miserably, so I don't expect you, the one who doesn't know the ABC of Arabic, to give any better answer. So last time, you know last time, was it her? And who's the other guy? Always forget his name. Who's your partner in crime?
Are you kidding me?
Not
Hatun.
Daniel. Yeah, you and Daniel came and approached me and Sheikh Mohammed regarding the same topic. You know why everyone was laughing at you in the comment section? Including the people that who know Arabic were Christians.
Yes,
because when they realized what she was actually saying and what the Arabic expert was saying, when the word, you know why Sheikh Mohammed asked the Arabic expert, the word Allah,
yes,
it says, in the Salat ala Nabi. When he says ala Nabi, it means greetings upon the messenger, depending on the context.
Prayer.
Because the context makes it clear whether it's prayer or it is greetings. It's salutation or is it worship?
It
is the context which makes it clear. But because she doesn't know Arabic, the reason she insists this is because that is what J. Smith taught her, to keep lying.
Exactly.
If you lie more often, then people start believing you. But we are Muslims, we don't go by that crazy logic. We can correct them of our faith. Okay, so now what was the second thing she said? She said that the Quran doesn't have consciousness. Because certain, no, she's right. Certain verses on the day of Qiyamah and the Quran itself will actually be transformed into a man, and transformation. I'm answering for you. Okay?
So let him answer,
Lizzy. Why you say for me? Calm down. So the Quran will intercede for you on the Yawm al Qiyamah, on the day of judgment. And you know what? This
which
is not
part,
the.
By the way?
Can I finish? I'll tell you which one.
Yeah,
the only one that we actually read. Which is the Al Quran. One Quran.
Right,
do you know Arabic, by the way? Do you know Arabic? Because the Quran is in Arabic. So no reason you're asking
but
which
you know
Quran. Because they have different Bibles.
Yes.
So they think we have the same thing.
Yes.
We have one Quran. So all the lies that they spread is completely wrong. So now going back to what she claimed, that the Quran has consciousness. You know what? This is on the Yawm al-Qiyamah. It is not only the Quran, which is actually the reward of those who recite the Quran. On the day of Qiyamah, it is also the
wait.
It is also all the recitation. It is also the. It is also the what do you say? The fasting. You know,
stop.
You know when you were talking, I did not interrupt.
Yes.
Can you give me the same courtesy?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Stop.
Lots of confusing
topic.
Things.
Well, if you got confusion, you know where to sort it out. There's something called a hospital there.
No.
Okay.
No.
So now, because what do you do when you keep lying? When you keep lying about Islam and about the Quran and about the Hadith, this is what happens. You get confusion because they do not go to the right sources. They go to these pseudo Arabic scholars, yes, Arabic experts who don't know the meaning of the word Allah. Okay. So now, listen. Bro. Wait, Lizzy,
I know
he's answering Islam. That's been done and dusted a long time ago. But they still go back and regurgitate the same thing. So now we have the fasting which will come in the form of a man as well.
Not even listening.
Yes, wacky, isn't it wacky?
Fasting will come in the form of a man. You know what will happen? This fasting is again the good deeds of the people who fast, which will come in the form of a man. Not the fasting itself, but the reward from the fasting. The reward also from the, not the Quran itself, not the speech of Allah, like Bob the Builder tried to say. Bob the Builder said that this is the speech of Allah, becoming it, the eternal speech of Allah is now transforming into a man. Just like Jesus transformed from God to a flesh and he died by his own creation. It's not like that. This is the good deeds, which is basically the recitation. You know when you recite, the Prophet said when you read the three letters of the Quran, like Alif, Lam, Mim, each letter you get 10 rewards. Not three letters is 10 rewards, each letter is 10 rewards. So if you read Alif, Lam, Mim, three letters, you get 30 rewards. And these are the good deeds of that person who's reciting the Quran, which will now transform into a man and intercede on his or her behalf. So there you go, Lizzy. All these wrong interpretations of the Hadith, you really have to get off your high horse and try to read. You know that Islam QA website which you went to? Go and read from that site. The one that you were really reluctant to see the meaning of. Because the detail was there already. That Hadith was there because the Muslims have asked this question.
But
they don't want to. They want to remain in their own world, you know? Go and stay in your own echo chamber and you will not learn anything. Try to come out of it. Try to learn from the authentic sources. That's the reason in the Bible you're unable to answer clear questions. If there is one God, then surely he has one consciousness. But she doesn't know that.
Can I respond?
To what?
To your ranting.
My ranting? Oh, you want where I destroyed your argument. Okay, carry on.
No, if only.
So, I did tell you, Lizzy, that you're going to say one, and I'm going to say one, and then we should stop the discussion.
You had your earlier already.
No,
it's my turn.
Now I think we should stop the discussion because I don't think she's able to answer
questions. The question.
Have you got a problem talking to that person you wanted to debate? Can you repeat your question? I think you find it a joke and silly that Christians talk to the Father, for example. No, I didn't say that was silly. I never said that was silly. Of course Jesus can talk to God. Which is not in the Bible. Which you are unable to show me.
I have shown you.
The Great Commission doesn't say the three are one. It doesn't say it's God. The only thing she could say is that one name. She said Jesus is Yahweh. Which is
actually
not answering the question.
Please ask your question.
Stop reading it on the version. Answer your question. Ask your question. Come on. By the way, this is what Ali Dawa would call the janaza of Lizzy. Carry on. By the way, janaza means funeral.
Oh, I knew that.
You don't need that. Good. At least you know some Arabic.
And I know what salat
is. You know what salat is? Okay, I think you should go and reconsult another Arabic expert, not a pseudo expert the last time you met. I hope you didn't pay. At least I hope you took the money back.
Okay, so here's the bit. God prayed to all humanity.
Oh, I see. But she'll use the same argument.
Okay, the same words. So God prayed to me.
In the Quran, Allah speech is talking to him.
Like
it says that in the Quran. Can you show me which verse?
Quran comes to life. Right?
Can you show me which verse the Quran talks?
Eternal speech talks to Allah.
Hello, Allah, how are you doing?
And yet this is
doesn't say that in the Quran.
Speech.
She knows that.
Isn't that mad?
And this is the lie. Are you going to show me the verse?
I'm
just going to make allegations.
That Allah is one. I just find
show me the verse then. Show me the verse where it says the Quran speaks to Allah.
You're meant to see. How can you do that without consciousness?
Show me from the Quran. You made an allegation. Okay. Otherwise, she'll be. It's okay. You can borrow our clip.
Camera here.
This is what happens when you work your camera on Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is run out of batteries.
Wow.
Wait. We got our own camera. If you want to borrow the clip, inshallah, the brothers will be able to share it with you. So I'm going to finish. I'm going to show us the evidence where Allah speaks. The Quran speaks to Allah. God.
No, the Quran speaks at all.
Show me where the Quran speaks to Allah.
No.
I already explained that to you. You were not listening. See, that's the problem.
I told her that
these were the deeds of the believers who read the Quran, which transforms into a man, and that is what is going to intercede. It is not the attribute of Allah which is going to intercede for them. I told this to Lizzy, but she's got a problem. Comprehending simple English, unfortunately.
I do, because that means you can't believe that the Quran is Allah's eternal.
The Quran, the speech of Allah is eternal.
Okay,
the Quran,
eternal
you know the Quran which you're holding in your hand there? Wait, the
is
Quran, hold on. The Quran, Allah, I'll answer. No, it's not a yes or no. I'll answer the way I want. Not the way you want, Lizzy. No. Like the way consciousness was straight and forward? Like the way consciousness was straight forward? No, you didn't answer that. You said, I didn't know. Okay, so now she's asking me another question. By the way, I only had one question to ask her. She asked me like a multiple questions. And I get no chance to ask her any questions. Now she's going to run away. Okay? So I think it's only fair that I ask a question instead of you asking me another one. I can quite easily answer that question after I ask you this.
You have not satisfied me.
You know,
the answer is.
Promise has
consciousness,
okay?
Let's maybe
just to be kind to you.
Eternal speech has consciousness. Where's the evidence for that? Where's the evidence for that?
I'll take away that phrase. But it developed a separate consciousness to go, hello, I want it.
I've already answered that. Now she's going back to the same argument which has been demolished already. No wonder you're running away now. Okay? So at the end of the day, she used the same argument that Bob the Builder uses, that the Quran intercedes. Quran intercedes for the believers on the day of judgment. Now, at the end of the day, we know very clearly from our ulamas, from our scholars, that the Quran, the attribute of Allah, is not the one that becomes a man. It is a good deed. Just like it says in the hadith also, that this is...
Come back.
Also in the hadith it says that the fasting will now become a man and intercede on behalf of the ones who are fasting. Okay? So we see this. This is the good deeds in terms of their fasting, which is going to take incarnate as a human being, and the good deeds is the one that is going to intercede on behalf of them in front of Allah. Very clear. You see, the reason they use these arguments of the Jahmis and of the Mu'tazilites, this has all been done in the past, in our history, in Islamic history, and our ulamas, alhamdulillah, have already addressed this very clearly. The reason they do not read that is because they think that they have found some sort of a loophole by reading and regurgitating the argument of the Jahmis and the Mu'tazilites. Yes, these people were considered heretics. It is like me going to someone like the Mormons, which the Christians consider as heretics, and using their arguments that God has multiple wives, yes, or that God, that all of them will become God one day, yes. If I use their arguments and say they claim themselves to be Christians, yes, I'm using their arguments against you. What will you tell me? You tell me no, get away from us. Those are heretics. We don't believe that they are even Christians. Well, the same goes with the Jahmis and the Mu'tazilites. They were heretics, discredited and refuted by our ulamas long time ago, yes, which they are now bringing back in the park. Unfortunately, they do not see the illogical fallacy that they've created here, which is basically already a refuted argument. They're trying to now bring it back, and we show them why this is not, the word Salat is not something which is a worship of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In fact, the entire Quran is a word of Allah and not Muhammad. Do you really think that if we worship both Allah and Muhammad, the Quran will not have any part for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have a sharing? Of course he will. There will be certain things mentioned from the hadith inside the Quran. Yes? That will tell us that this, who is really committing shirk here? It is they who believe that we are committing shirk when we never claim that Muhammad is only a messenger of Allah. In fact, from day one, when the Muslim takes his shahada, what does he declare? That I declare that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. So from day one we declare, we testify that Allah is the one who is the Rabb, is the one worthy of worship, and there is no deity worth worshipping except Allah. And Muhammad is but a messenger of Allah, and his servant and his slave. Just like Jesus was a servant and a slave. Jesus says this in the Bible, that he's a servant and a slave. Okay, he says he's a servant. Maybe translating it only as servant. But this is clearly showing you that Jesus cannot be the God, cannot be the master if he claims he's a servant. Yes? They keep saying that this is in his humanity. But guess what? In his humanity, he was still that one person of the second person of the Trinity. So the second person of the Trinity, in his humanity, while he's having the divinity, is claiming that he's a servant of the Most High. There you go, Jesus telling you he's not the master, but the servant. Got killed by his own disciple, sorry, by his own creation. That is the most absurd thing I would believe about God Almighty, who has power over all things, yes? Who has knowledge of all things. Guess what? Jesus did not even know the last hour. When he was asked the question, he says, only the Father. Yes, again showing you the distinction between the knowledge he has and the knowledge the Father has. The Father is, sorry, not the Father, God. Sorry, he says the Father, yeah. The Father is all knowledgeable. And this all knowledgeable shows you that he's much more powerful than the one who doesn't even know the last hour. He didn't know the difference between a tree not bearing fruit outside the season of fig and a tree bearing fruit inside the season of fig. So Jesus one day was hungry. Listen, the most powerful God of Lizzy got hungry one day. And guess what? He approaches this fig tree. And then he realizes that there are no figs on it. Guess what? The most powerful God, because he's very powerful, he decides to curse the tree. And the tree withers and dies within a few days or whatever, very quickly basically. What was the fault of the tree? Wasn't the tree, the fig tree, acting according to the will of God? Wasn't the tree submitting to the will of God that it can only bear fruit in the season of figs, not outside the season? This is the nature of that fig tree, which Jesus should have known, okay? Jesus should have known this. At the end of the day, if they don't know, if Jesus did not know this simple piece of information, which even a farmer at that time would have pointed out to him, then how can you call him the most powerful God? And he curses a perfectly good fruit-bearing tree, which someone could have taken shade under, which someone could have benefited from the fruits when it actually came to the season of figs. Yes, he cursed that tree for no reason.
Is it okay? A literal story?
Because this is something, is you tell me, go and ask the Christians. Because if it was allegorical, then they could have just said, Jesus could have just explained it to them. That if this is what was supposed to be for Israel, supposed to be some sort of a foretelling of Israel, what happens to them if they disobey or something, then he could have just said it in front of destroying a tree. Today, many of us, even the atheists, even the non-Muslims and non-Christians, even they say we should not indulge in deforestation. We should not cut down trees unnecessarily. And Jesus is going against this very thing of deforesting, or basically killing a tree unnecessarily, when he did not have the fruit. Why was Jesus looking when he was hungry? Why does it say when he was hungry? If it was allegorical, what was he hungry for?
Isn't it an allegorical story?
Answer the question, what was he hungry for? Because the verse in Matthew clearly says he was hungry. Was it Mark, I think? He says he was hungry and he approached a tree. If it was just allegorical, he doesn't need to say that, does it? The only reason your powerful God, Lizzy, got hungry is because he wasn't God at all. He was a servant of God. And with that, we complete this discussion and this debate. Unfortunately, it was very bad for Lizzy, because summarizing this particular debate was really clear cut that what Lizzy was saying about things like God, that the Quran will intercede and all that, I clarified that these things are not to be taken like the way Lizzy reads them. Now, if this is clear, then you should not use the same argument again. But we know very clearly from the DCCI and from Bob the Builder, they'll come back with the same argument again. Because we know for a fact this is what J. Smith used to do. He used to repeat a lie, repeat a lie, repeat a lie, until all the DCCI people, all the Fander people, and people like Bob the Builder started believing it. Guess what? The very source that they took the information from was a habitual liar, a compulsive liar, which he has been caught out time and time again. Just like Lizzy doesn't know Arabic, he also did not know Arabic. To use the word Salat, Alan Nabi, yes, is clear to anyone who is not even a Muslim but knows Arabic. And they will even tell you that this is not what you understand as a non-Arabic speaking person. Because in English, the word prayer can mean only prayer. What prayer means to pray five times a day, for example. In English, it also can mean supplication. Yes, it can also mean, if I tell someone, pray for me, yes, if I tell you, pray for me, or if Lizzy tells their people, pray for the ones who have passed, you know, like they say, rest in peace. Rest in peace is a prayer, yes? Are you praying to the dead? Is Lizzy committing shirk there? Is she praying and worshipping the dead? Because rest in peace is a very common English term, which all the English speaking people or those who understand English will understand. This is a prayer for the ones who have died. Rest in peace. Very simple. So with that, I think we have done the janaza and the rest in peace goes perfectly. To Lizzy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.